Hello, chosen ones. How are you? I hope everyone is blessed and doing great. I don't know when you may see this video, but when you do, I hope you are highly favored that day and forever, that you are blessed. You are having a great day. You are prosperous in life. You are speaking affirmations over yourself, positive affirmations. I am whole. I am bold. I am brave. I am healed. I am beautiful. I am handsome. I hope you all are speaking affirmations over yourself. But I wanted to talk to you all about money. Controlling your money, not letting the money control you. And God wants us to have money because we have to advance His kingdom of God. So He wants us to have money, but it is the way that you feel about money. Is you letting it control your life, or are you controlling it? So I'm going to go to Matthew 6:24. In verse 6:24, He says, the title of it is, "You cannot serve God in riches." No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will be loyal to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Okay? So, just in case no one know what mammon is, that's like an evil spirit. That's something that you is worshiping more than God, and we don't want to do that at all. So a way that you can know that you are serving the money and not God is by just like recklessly spending it, like just spending it just because you have it. You're not saving it up at all. You're not using it for the glory of God. That's how you can know that you is spending money and you is serving money and not God. That is the main reason you can know. If you're not doing anything for God with your money, you're not paying your tithes, you're not giving, you're not helping out in no type of way. You just like splurging it and using it all on yourself. That's not doing good with your money at all. Not at all. And God don't want us to be like that, because we have to serve Him, serve His kingdom. You have to pay your tithes. Every time you get some money, where do you think it's coming from? It's coming from God. Yes, you may be working a job or whatever, but how you think you got that job? You got that job through God. Nothing that we have belongs to us and comes from us or someone else. It comes from God, putting it in that person's heart to give it to you. So if you're not planning and saving your money, that is a bad thing. That's not a good thing to do. I'm going to go to another scripture. This scripture is in Timothy. When you lose scriptures, I don't like that. Because I had it folded up. And now, here we 16. 1 Timothy 6:10. "But those who desire to be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and harmful jests, which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil, for which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness, and pierced themselves through with many sorrows." And that is in 1 Timothy 9:10. I'm sorry. So, see in verse 10, it says that money is the root of all evil. It's greediness. God don't want us to be greedy. He wants us to share and advance His kingdom of God. And if we is not doing that, We is not doing right. We is not doing right. It's another scripture in Romans 12 verse 2. It says, do not conform to the patterns of this world. Be renewed by the renewing of your mind. You have to renew your mind. You have to plan ahead. Get you a bank account. Do something positive with your money. Pay your tithes. Giving, give, 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 give.